Hello friends, my name is B.K. Kollapre. In this video, we'll study about the chapter friction here. Now here, if I take a surface, if the surface is rough and if I keep the body on the surface, if W is the weight of the body, since there is contact, there will be definitely reaction acting perpendicular to the surface. If I apply force P towards right, this body has tendency to move towards right. Now suppose if I take a surface and if I keep a body, if I want to move this body, it is seen that there is a resistance offered at the surface of contact against the movement of the body. This resistance offered at the surface of contact, we call it as the friction. Friction is the resistance offered by the surface at the contact when the body tends to move over it. And this force of friction always acts in a direction opposite to the force or the motion trend. Now with this force, the body has tendency to move motion trend. It has tendency to move towards right. That means force of friction should be always opposite to the direction of motion. So the force of friction will be acting on the at the surface of contact in the opposite direction. So these forces will keep the body in equilibrium. Here we come across some terms known as coefficient of friction. Coefficient of friction, we generally abbreviate it as mu. This coefficient of friction is nothing but it is the ratio of force of friction to normal reaction. Force of friction to normal reaction. So mu is equal to force of friction, if I call it as F, and R is the normal reaction, or usually we will be using the relation F is equal to mu R. F is equal to mu R. Now the reason why this friction is coming into play is, suppose if I see it's a small portion under microscope, you find there are undulations on both sides of the surface. If I keep one over the other, there are interlocking of the projections that are there, due to which if I try to move, it will be giving a resistance. More are the undulations or projections, more is the resistance offered by the surface, more will be the friction. Now this is the definition of coefficient of friction. The second definition we see is angle of friction. Angle of friction. Suppose if I call this as phi, suppose there is a body, it has got its weight W, R is the normal reaction, P is the force acting, F is the force of friction as we see here. Now here at the contact there are two forces. One is the reaction vertically up, another force is the force of friction up. We know any number of forces acting can be replaced by a single force known as the resultant force. Now suppose if I show the resultant of these two forces by an arrow here like this. This is the resultant I called as R dash. So R dash is the resultant of the normal reaction and the force of friction. This angle we call it as the angle of friction. So angle of friction is the angle made by the resultant of force of friction and normal reaction with the normal or with the vertical. So this is known as the force of friction. This we write is as tan phi is equal to F by R, and F by R we have seen just now is nothing but mu. So all these relations are same. Mu is equal to F by R, which will be equal to tan phi. So this is the angle of friction. We come across another term known as angle of repose. Angle of repose. Now suppose if I take a surface if I place a body over this, the surface is horizontal. Now what I will do, for example, if I show it here, if this is the surface, if I keep a body over this surface, I have kept a body over the surface. Now what I'll do? I'll go on slight inclining the surface. See, in the initial period, there is no slipping of the body there. At certain angle, it will start slipping down. So here, if I show that slipping of the force or the body in the downward direction, so here, if I go on increasing the angle, there is certain angle at which it will be sliding down, on the verge of sliding down. This angle we call it as the angle of repose. So angle of repose is the angle made by the inclined plane when the body is on the verge of sliding down. It's not sliding, it is on the verge of sliding, or we call it as impend motion, verge of sliding, or we call it as impend motion. So this angle is known as the angle of repose. So we come across another term known as cone of friction. Cone of friction. Shape of cone. This cone is known as the cone of friction. Now how this cone is formed? Now just now we have seen, if there is a body, it has got its weight, it will be having its reaction. If I pull the body towards right, the force of friction will be towards left. Now these two forces, R and F, if I replace by a single force, this is R and this is F. So you get the resultant is acting in this direction. And this angle we call it as an angle of friction phi. Now here, these two forces are there when P is towards right, means the body is moving towards right, the resultant reaction will be towards left. Or if I remove this P and show the P on this side, the body will move towards left. So in that thing, what happened? This reaction R will be moving towards right like this, opposite. When I am pulling right, this is there, R dash. When I am pulling left, this is their R dash. Now what I will do, I will pull it out. So when I pull it out, the force of friction will go backside the board. Or if I push the board, the reaction will be acting like this. Now here we are seeing in all the directions the reactions are acting. And if I join all the points here, we get a cone known as cone of friction. So this is an inverted cone. This is a cone of friction. And this is a semi-vertex angle phi. So this is the O and this is the normal reaction R. So what is cone of friction? Cone of friction is the cone obtained by joining the locus of the point with O as the pivot, making semi-vertex angle phi and phi. This is like your inverted topi of a joker. Inverted joker topi. That's known as a cone of friction. So these are some of the definitions which you are supposed to know before going to this problems. Now here we come across the laws of friction. These are the laws of friction that you come in across. So first law is force of friction always acts in a direction opposite to the motion plane. This is very important law. Force of friction always acts in a direction opposite to the motion trend, not opposite to the force. It always opposes the motion trend. The magnitude of the limiting friction bears a constant ratio with normal reaction. We have seen just now the coefficient of friction is F by R. It bears a constant ratio. Third law is the maximum force when the body is at rest is equal to the limiting friction. Now suppose if I go on applying force to this body, I have applied one force, the body is not moving. I'll apply two forces, the body is not moving. Now I'll apply three forces, now just the body starts sliding. So this maximum force, what I am applying, is equal to the maximum friction that will be acting at the surface of contact. And this maximum friction we call it as the limiting friction when the body is on the verge of sliding. And how much maximum force I can apply, that will be equal to the limiting force which is acting at the surface of contact. Next is force of friction is independent of the area of contact. Whether it is small contact area or big contact area, there is no difference. The force of friction depends upon the roughness of the surface. Just now we have seen, more is the roughness of the surface, more are the projections, and interlocking will be strong and it will be difficult for you to move. So more is the roughness, more is the friction that will be offered by the body. So this is a theoretical background which is usually asked in the examination. Now based upon this theoretical background, we will go for some problems here. Let us take a simple problem. Now here this is a problem. A block is resting on a rough surface, is attached to a string which passes round a frictional spley as shown in figure. So this is a block, it has got its weight of 1000 newton, it is tied with a string and this string is passing round a pulley and a 100 newton load is hanging there. So find the value of the horizontal force P such that if the motion is impending towards right, first case, and if the motion is impending towards left. So left and right, they are the motion trends. So here we will be solving the problem for both the cases. First case is impend motion towards right. Impend motion towards right. So here we will draw the free body diagram. Now here if you see, this string is passing round a pulley. It is carrying a load of 100 newton. Whatever load is acting, that will be the tension in the string. If I call T is the tension in the string, this T will be equal to 100 newton. Now this string is passing round the pulley. We know whenever the string passes round a pulley, the tension on either side of the pulley will remain the same. So here also the tension will be T is equal to 100 because it is passing round the pulley. And we know tension is away from the end. Now with this detail, we can take the free body diagram of the block here. So tension T will be equal to 100 newton. Consider FBD of block. FBD of block. What is FBD? Free body diagram of a block. So free body diagram is a diagram free from the surface of contact. The surface of contact is replaced by the normal reaction which keeps the body in equilibrium. So I will separate out this body. It has got its own weight, 1000 newton. It is subjected to a force of P. There is a tension acting here, T is equal to 100 newton. And this is making an angle of 30 degrees. These are the visible. Now the forces that get induced are, one is, there is contact, so there will be reaction. Now this is moving towards right. So the motion trend is, motion trend is right, so the force of friction will be towards left, F. And we know F is equal to mu R. In this problem, you take the value of mu is equal to 0.3. So this will be equal to mu R means 0.3 R. Now these forces keep the body in equilibrium. So whenever they are in equilibrium, we will apply the equilibrium condition sigma 0, sigma V 0 and sigma M 0. So if I resolve the forces vertically and equate it to 0, R is acting vertically up, then the force of the body, 1000 is acting down is negative. And this force, 100, if I resolve it vertically, away from the angle, up is positive, away from the angle is sin theta. So sin 30, this will be equal to 0. If you simplify for R, you get the value of R is equal to 950 newton. Now we'll use the second equilibrium condition. Let us resolve all the forces horizontally and equate it to 0. If I resolve the forces horizontally, this P is acting towards right. Right we take it as positive. This force 0.3 R is acting towards left. So this will be minus 0.3 into R. And this force, if I resolve it horizontally, it is along the angle and towards left. So minus 100 sine of 30, cos of 30 is equal to 0. So P will be equal to 0.3 into, we know the value of R is 950 minus 100 cos of 30. So this value of P, what we get is 37.16 Newton. So this is the force required for the body to make it to move towards right. Now we'll go for the second case, impelled motion towards left. If I take it towards left, see what will be the difference it will be taking place. Again, let us consider the free body diagram. Weight is 1000 Newton, tension in the string is 30 degrees, 100 Newton at 30 degrees, P is the force acting. Here, the motion trend is towards left. When the motion trend is towards left, the force of friction will be towards right, opposite to the motion trend. Now with this, again we will resolve the forces vertically and horizontally. If I resolve the force vertically, the result remains same. Minus 1000 plus R plus 100 sine 30. So R value remains the same as 950 Newton. Now if I resolve the forces horizontally, this P is acting horizontally towards right. This 0.3 R is also acting towards right. So this becomes positive. And this 100, if I resolve it horizontally, along the angle it is acting towards left. And if I simplify this, by substituting the value of R, P is equal to 100 cos of 30 minus 0.3 into R. R is here 950. So the value of P, what we get after simplification, is 198.34. So you get a force of minus 198. So here the value of P, which is shown towards right, will be changing its sign towards left. That means instead of pulling the body, you'll have to push the body with a force of 198.34, because it is negative here. So instead of pull, it should be pushed. So what is the answer? You write the values here. It depends upon the magnitude of P and the force of friction and the normal reaction, weight of the body. So these are the types of problems that you'll be coming across in friction. So motion trend is important here, whether left or right. Motion trend and force of friction, they always oppose each other. Please subscribe the channel for more videos. Press the bell icon for notification. In comment section, you can ask any questions. Thank you.